It's like the most popular wilderness area in the country. People come up here with the idea that they're going to be in true pristine wilderness and they're going to be just them and nature.
The Boundary Waters is very unique in that it is very untouched. The ecosystems are pristine and unlike anywhere else.
I wanted to get at how pristine is this? I mean, we try to do the leave no trace. You clean up your campsite, you clean up after yourself, you leave no trace. But what is that? How good are we at that? And microplastics, I think, are something that's been overlooked.
Microplastics are any plastic filament, fragment, or bead smaller than 0.5 millimeters. Microplastics can come from your clothing. They shed off of synthetic material. Especially here, they come from like tarps you lay down, your tent.
So everything that we bring in that's packaged in plastic, eventually that plastic material breaks down, but it doesn't completely disappear. It just breaks down into smaller pieces of plastic, and then it's just kind of everywhere.
I'll get my setup going again. We're collecting a lot of different types of samples here, mainly water, lake bottom sediment. We've collected sediment from onshore. We're also doing worms and crayfish.
We found like 80 pieces, microplastics in one worm, and that blew me away. I just thought, wow. Okay, well that tells you for sure there's a lot of microplastics at the campsites because that's where the worms came from. But they're consuming them too. And if the worms are getting them, then so are the things that are eating the worms.
Worms will also act as transport for those microplastics, bringing them further down. The further they go down into the soil, the closer they are to the groundwater.
We went to Pine Lake and we took samples from depth at 40 feet down, 20 feet down, 15 feet down, and on the surface, and we found microplastics in all the layers.
Ultimately, you know, animals in the water are going to be consuming the microplastics, so then that's just going to remain in their systems, and then when we consume them, it's going to come into our systems as well, and you just can't break it down, so then eventually, who knows how much microplastics we're really going to have in us, in the trophic levels, in like the waters.
This is the first time I've ever done research. I really enjoy, you know, the wilderness in general. It's kind of why I got into my degree, is because I really enjoy nature itself. So just the thought of how all these plastic materials, which when they're breaking down, they release toxins into the environment, and then it can be taken up by other animal life. It just really makes you think about, you know, our impact.
I've got a connection to the Boundary Waters. I think a lot of people do. This people are really passionate about this place. It's a beautiful area, and I think people, you really get a connection with nature here that you might not get in other places.
Honestly, this research cohort has opened me up to so many opportunities and kind of helped me navigate into what I want to do. I am honestly shocked at how much I've learned from this research. I had no idea what went into creating a procedure, a real procedure that no one's ever done before, creating our own methods and finding ways to process the samples that we collect.
I love the Boundary Waters. This will be my fourth time being up here. We have a lot more one-on-one time. We are way more hands-on. We get to do a little bit of everything.
1 hour out here is worth like a semester's worth in a classroom.
Got it.
They've taken the research, they've made it their own, and they're running with it. And it's great. I mean, I love seeing it. I love it when students, you know, they get into it. They really get psyched by what they're doing.
We have a group of 4 students and Dr. Wellnitz, and that's a quite small research group. You learn a lot more and you can see the whole concept of the research, and that just helps you get a better idea of the process.
When we are looking at the worms under the microscope, you would never expect to see what you do. And to see the light fibers and taking the UV light to them and seeing them fluoresce under the UV is just, it's a really cool experience.
I think this research has made it a little easier to understand why we do certain things in the classroom. Like, it really kind of helped me understand why we step back and read other people's research, because it kind of helps you develop your research path. Just being the first to do research in a heavily trafficked wilderness area, just one of the biggest ones in the country, is really awesome.
It's a big deal, and it seems to be ubiquitous. It seems like this is something that's all over the planet, and we've only just realized it. And there is no such thing as, well, pristine anymore, because there's no place you can go that they're not.